sleigh bells ring. Are you listening? In the lane, snow is glistening.
A our Christmas meal?
Big. Is all I can say. It's huge.
We have what we call the wafer. It's called a płatki in Polish. And you're supposed to, everybody's supposed to get a piece, and then they're supposed to go to everybody, and you chip off a piece, and you wish them a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year, you know, a healthful New Year. But our family got so big, now we just break it and put it on a plate, and everybody takes it and say Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.
It's a wonderful, wonderful table, and you just keep filling your plate and thinking you're going to be able to eat everything you put on there, but no person can do it.
We have kielbasa, we have pierogies, we have ham, and marshmallow salad, and jello salad, and vegetables. It's just great.
And we've got fresh horseradish, which is excellent. Puts hair on your chest. And it's just a smorgasbord of everything.
We have lasagna. I'm not sure how that became Polish.
The kruszczykis. The kruszczykis are good. They got powdered sugar on them, and it's a real thin dough, and you have to put it into the deep fry for a couple of seconds, bring it out, and then the powdered sugar goes on. But you can't breathe in when you eat them or you'll choke to death.
The fiddles now. There's wine to warm the middles now.
We have, kielbasa is great. I've had that since I was a kid. Pierogies, to die for. Potatoes and onions, they're just great. And kruszczykis is the dessert. Oh, it's just wonderful. You know, the pierogies, the Polish people don't only make with potatoes in it. They make it with sauerkraut in it too, and cottage cheese. But the pierogies with the potatoes and onions are my favorite. Or my mother used to make it with fried cabbage. Oh, that is so good. The only part about that is that when you'd be frying that cabbage, you just put it on a low fire and you just keep turning it, and you put salt and pepper in it. But I kept tasting it. I don't know how much of that cabbage was left over, you know, after. But I guess I'd have to go with kielbasa. But, oh, that pierogies is strong first.
Kielbasa, but it's, kielbasa. That'll do it for me. That's one of the favorites, and it will never die. It's the best ever. And I helped make it last Christmas.
That's tough. My two favorites would be the kielbasa and the pierogies, because they just go so well together.
Kielbasa.
Pierogies. No, the kielbasa and pierogies run together. Because basically, you can't have one without the other.
My mother and dad made kielbasa, and it was good kielbasa, so good that people that were getting married would order so many pounds of kielbasa, and my mom and daddy would make it and sell it. And then on Easter, always Easter, they had so much. They had a commercial grinder in the basement, a commercial thing. So sometimes I would go over to my mom and dad and help them when they had a whole lot to make the kielbasa. And then when I moved here to Texas, my daddy sent me the recipe for the kielbasa, and I won't give it out to anybody because that's a family recipe. Nobody gets that, you know. And so I started making it here. My kids are spoiled. They don't like any other fresh kielbasa but grandma's.
Frosty the snowman was a jolly happy soul, with a corncob pipe and a button nose, eyes made out of...
And then all the grandchildren go and they say happy birthday to baby Jesus. And I'll always ask the youngest one why, and they'll say because without baby Jesus being born, there's no Christmas. And then we get to sing. Off key, but it's great. Everybody gets to sing.
We have the grandkids pick a song from the youngest. They go to the oldest and they get to pick a song they want to sing. And everybody gets to sing, and we don't sing very well, but we put our heart into it.
None of us can sing on key, except Mom.
All I know is that we have a lot of bad singers.
It's actually kind of scary at times, but because none of us can sing, it brings us all together, and it's a fun, festive occasion, and I wouldn't miss it for the world.
some of the songs they pick are really funny, like Grandma Got Run Over by a Reindeer, which really isn't a Christmas carol, but and we got that, and of course White Christmas and Frosty the Snowman and Rudolph, and the kids get a big kick out of it, and I enjoy watching the younger ones. And the older ones start giggling at times, and that's even funnier yet.
Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane. Vixen and Blitzen and all his reindeer are pulling on the rein.
As far back as I can remember, we have had Santa come visit on Christmas Eve.
Santa's visit with his elves. You never know what the elves are going to wear when they come in.
Well, actually, the elves are kind of big. They're a little bit oversized, but you know, right now we're in Texas and everything's bigger in Texas, so that explains the elves.
The excitement of waiting and the anticipation of hearing the footsteps on the roof and the reindeer hooves on the roof and just seeing the kids' expressions as Santa comes in and seeing brothers and sisters' expressions as the Santa Claus comes in is wonderful.
So I don't know what goes on downstairs, but I hear it's pretty wild. I'm always upstairs with the reindeer, so I couldn't tell you pretty much that. The reindeers do some drinking, though, before the flight. They booze it up pretty good.
We always had Santa. When we lived in Michigan, my mother always had Santa Claus come to the house, and so I always had the suit. And when we came here to Texas, it just, that tradition just had to live on. You know, when you grow up and you stop believing in Santa Claus, there's a little bit of magic that goes out of the Christmas. But I found out when my kids were born, the magic came back. You're just watching your kids, the magic comes back. It's there, and it's the greatest feeling. It just blossoms in your chest, and it's just so wonderful to see. So that tradition has never died, and I hope to gosh it never does.
Jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
The first time that Santa asked me to be one of his elves, and having some green boxers, Hawaiian shirt, gloves, Santa hat, and sunglasses, it was an elf made in heaven.
I can remember being as a child. We would come down, and we had, my family had 8 kids in the family, so we lived in a 2-story house, and the bedrooms were upstairs, and we would come down the stairs, and we'd have to wait on the stairs until Dad got his video camera going. But this video camera was not like one that we have now, and it was huge, and it had these, they looked like 6 floodlights just all on it, and we had to wait until he had that going, and then we would walk into the room and everybody'd be just, oh my God, my eyes. And it was just, you were just blinded by this light. And then, but after you got used to it, you just seen the living room was just full of gifts. It was great. Every year we had to do that, and I just loved it.
Watching my dad sit back and watch everybody, and you could see it in his eyes. He was just so happy, and the twinkle in his eyes. My dad could be a difficult man at times, but come Christmas Eve, he just loved having everybody around, and what I wouldn't give to have those times back.
When my kids were little, the first time they actually experienced Santa Claus coming through the front door and seeing their expressions, something that you'll never forget.
I think one year my grandson Ryan, he was only a little tyke, and I asked him what he wanted for Christmas, and he says Cocoa Puffs, because Mama won't buy them because they're too expensive. So of course Grandpa was Santa Claus, and he said we're gonna get him the Cocoa Puffs. So the first thing that happened when Santa Claus came in, he had the Cocoa Puffs behind his back, and he said, Ryan, I heard that you want something special for Christmas. And he brought out the Cocoa Puffs, and Ryan's eyes got so big, and he was so happy. That was one of my favorites.
Ah. Christmas. You can plan.
Too many of my friends and too many people I know, they don't really like their family. And in our family, everybody loves being around each other, except for Kim. We don't like her. But no, everybody loves being around each other, and I think that's what makes it special more than anything else, is just the love and just, you know, just the fun, the camaraderie, everything. Just, that's what makes it special more than anything else.
Love. Love, I think. Love, family, very important to everybody. And fun. Everybody likes to have fun. Everybody teases everybody else. Everybody just enjoys each other's company.
Because we're a family and we love everybody and we're all so close, that's why it could never be anything better.
Sisters, brothers, brother-in-laws, nieces, nephews, and as the family expands, the cousins or the nieces and nephews that get married and bring in their families and their husbands, it's just special that we're all together the one time a year that everybody's under the same roof and just having fun.
The family together, the pictures we take, the giggling. I can look at each one, and you know, there's talking over here on one side of the room, talking on the other. There's just the constant talking, and it's not a click, you know? I mean, and I enjoy seeing my grandchildren get along so good with their aunts and uncles. There's like, there is no years between them.
It's not the singing or the gifts or Santa coming. It is just family, being together, enjoying one another's company. And to me, that is Christmas.